فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. سورة النازعات، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والنازعات غرقا والناشطات نشطا والسابحات سبحا فالسابقات سبقا فالمدبرات أمرا يوم ترجف الراجفة تتبعها الرادفة قلوب يومئذ واجفة أبصارها خاشعة يقولون أئنا لمردودون في الحافرة أئذا كنا عظاما نخرة قالوا تلك إذا كرة خاسرة فإنما هي زجرة واحدة فإذا هم بالساهرة هل أتاك حديث موسى إذ ناداه ربه بالوادي المقدس طوى اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل هل لك إلى أن تزكى وأهديك إلى ربك فتخشى فأراه الآية الكبرى فكذب وعصى ثم أدبر يسعى فحشر فنادى فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى أأنتم أشد خلقا أم السماء بناها رفع سمكها فسواها وأغطش ليلها وأخرج ضحاها والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم فإذا جاءت الطامة الكبرى يوم يتذكر الإنسان ما سعى وبرزت الجحيم لمن يرى فأما من طغى وآثر الحياة الدنيا فإن الجحيم هي المأوى وأما من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى فإن الجنة هي المأوى يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها فيما أنت من ذكراها إلى ربك منتهاها إنما أنت منذر من يخشاها كأنهم يوم يرونها لم يلبثوا إلا عشية أو ضحاها. والنازعات غرقا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he swears by those who extracted with violence. The Mufassirin, the scholars of tafsir, when it came to the meaning of the word wannazi, a green jaguar, PLO5UWJ, if you can move your car. I think you've parked in the wrong place. وَالنَّازِعَاتِ غَرْقَى, by those who extract with violence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is swearing, he's making an oath. And he is making an oath on those who extract with violence. But who are those who extract with violence? The Mufassirin, the scholars of tafsir, differed on this issue. Who is referred to as those who extract with violence? With five opinions, five aqwal, five views. The first qawl is those who said it's the angels. And they're the angels that are taking specifically the ruh of the kafirin, the disbelievers. And the way that they're extracting it from that disbeliever is with violence. That's one qawl. And this view is attributed to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Abdullah ibn Abbas and Masruq and Sa'id ibn Jubayr. Those four. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Masruq and Sa'id ibn Jubayr. Those four is attributed to them that the Nazi'ati Gharqa here is the angels extracting the soul out of the body of the disbeliever with violence. And Allah uses specifically the word gharqa, meaning he drowns inside it. The second is the death, when it's being taken out of, the soul is being taken out of the person's body by death coming to them. So when everybody dies, the body is being taken out and the eyes follow it. This is what's meant by it, they said. And this is a qawl attributed to Mujahid ibn Jabrin, rahimahullah. The third is the stars. When they move from one ufuq, one horizon to another, this is what's meant by it, they said. This view is attributed to Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah, and Qatadat ibn Da'amat al-Sadusi. The fourth one is, the fourth view is what's meant by wal-nazi'at, that Allah is swearing by here and making an oath, is meant by al-qusiyu tunza'u bis-sahmi. When the arrow goes through the bow, Allah is swearing by that. The way it goes through it fast, Allah is swearing by that. And this is attributed to Ata. The fourth and last one is النَّفْسُ حِينَ تُنْزَعُ. So al-mawtu, the first one, the second view that I mentioned was what? Al-mawtu yunza'u nafs. That the death takes the soul, right? The death is what takes the soul. And here number five is the soul when it's being taken out of the body, generally speaking. And this is attributed to Sudi. And this is the weakest of the five. So why is it that all of these scholars differed on this verse? The reason why the khilaf came regarding this verse is because Allah mentions a description which can be attributed to all of those that are mentioned. Is what the Mufassirin call it, أَوْصَافٌ لَمْ يُذْكَرْ مَوْصُوفُهَا. Description. Those who stand up to do that description are many. All five of them are like that. So we say this is from the two types of khilaf. There's two. When you look at the Quran, the scholars differ, there's two types of differences. There's sometimes when they differ, it's called ikhtilaf al-tadad, where we can't reconcile between their statements. But ikhtilaf al-tanawwu' means when we can bring all their views together. Huh? We can bring all of their views together, which is that the ayah is general and it means everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since He left it ambiguous and He only mentioned the characteristics, it can be all of them. That's what the view Ibn Jarir al-Tabari took. Ibn Jarir al-Tabri, Imam al-Mufassirin, he said that the ayah should be left general. But two things don't let it be general. Two things doesn't allow the verse to be general. And it narrows it down to the angel specifically, that is specific to the malaika. Two things. The first one is السياق من المقيدات. The context restricts it. The context doesn't allow it. Why? In the ayah, there's going to come to us, inshallah ta'ala, or in the surah, there's an ayah where Allah says, فَالْمُدَبِّرَاتِ أَمْرًا. The ones who run Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's affairs, meaning, and those who arrange each matter. The mufassirin by consent, all of them, and inshallah ta'ala, we're going to bring that consent, they all agree that the فَالْمُدَبِّرَاتُ here is meant by the angels. They all agree. All of the ones who differed here, they don't differ on the فَالْمُدَبِّرَاتِ. They all said it's the angels. So if the mudabbirat is the angels, where is that fat going to? The fat is going to what was previously mentioned. The fat in fal mudabbirat is saying, and those who arrange matters, who's and those? It's those who were previously mentioned. Are you with me, brothers? Meaning the angels. So if you agree the mudabbirat are the angels, and it's saying and, the context shows that what's previously been spoken about is the angels. Number one. The second thing that shows that it's the angels is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad. This hadith is very long, and inshallah ta'ala we're going to take it in its totality. This hadith is Jabir Bara ibn Azim, sorry, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, kharajna ma'an nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we went out with the Prophet one day. Fi janazatin, in a janaza. And the janaza was a janaza of a man. Min al ansari, this man was from the people of Ansar. And you know the Muslims are two, right? The Muhajirina who came from Mecca, and the Ansar who were the resident of Medina. So the Sahaba Bara ibn Azim said, we went out with the Prophet and we were burying a man from the people of Ansar. Fantahayna ila al qabri, we stopped at the grave. We came to the grave now, we're at the grave. ولما يلحد فجلس رسول الله. The man got placed in his grave. And lahd means when the grave is made, there's a part within the grave that's dug. In this country, is it done? No, they don't do that. They don't do lahd. Lahd means when the grave is made, inside again there's a part in it. So the person is put inside and then squeezed under. When the man got put in his grave and he got put in, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the Sahabas, all of them sat. The Prophet sat and they sat with him. Just to show you the obedience of the companions. When they sat down, the Sahaba said, وَجَلَسْنَا حَوْلَهُ, we sat around the Prophet. وَكَأَنَّ عَلَىٰ رُؤُسِنَا الطَّيْرِ, it is as though birds are on our heads. Meaning, عَدَمُ التَّحَرُّكُ, no one's moving. Everybody is still listening attentively everything that the Prophet is going to say. عليه الصلاة والسلام. And how they sat around him. When he sat, he didn't tell them sit down. Obedient students, obedient followers, they all sat around him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, and at that point the Prophet had a twig in his hand. وفي يده عود, he had a twig in his hand. عليه الصلاة والسلام, ينكت في الأرض, he was scribbling on the earth. فرفع رأسه, the Prophet's head was down, and he raised his head. And then he said to his companions, "Ista'udu billahi min adab al-qabr." Seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. Seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. Seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. Marratayn aw thalathan. He said it twice or three times. The Prophet repeated this. Seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. Then the Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, إن العبد المؤمن, the believer who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, that his iman was not مجرد الدعاوة, it wasn't just a mere claim. He lived by Islam, قلبا وقالبا, internally and externally. He lived by Islam. إذا كان في انقطاع من الدنيا, when he's leaving this world and he's departing from this world, وإقبال من الآخرة, and he's facing the hereafter. And that's the reality of everybody. We are heading towards the hereafter. It's funny, a group of people celebrate their birthdays. They're celebrating a moment in which they're getting closer to their graves, that they're getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك علي بن أبي طالب said, كونوا من أبناء الآخرة ولا تكونوا من أبناء الدنيا. Be from the children of the hereafter and the people of the hereafter. Don't be from the people of this dunya. So when the believer is leaving this world, he's departing from this world, and he is facing the hereafter. نزل إليه ملائكة من السماء. Angels will come and ascend down to him from the sama. The description of these angels are, as the Prophet said to us, بيض الوجوه. Their faces are white. كأن وجوههم الشمس. It's like their faces is the sun. معهم كفن. These angels, they have shrouds with them. من أكفان الجنة وحنوط من حنوط الجنة. It is mixed. The word hanut in the Arabic language is طيبٌ يختلطُ للميتي. It's specifically something that's added together and it's washed with the dead body of the... The smell here is very strong. It smells very nice. But it's taken from paradise, Jannah. These angels, they will sit. يَجْلِسُونَ مِنْهُ مَدَّ الْبَصَرِ. They will sit from where he... an eyesight. They can see. ثُمَّ يَجِيءُ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ. Then the angels of angel of death will specifically come. These angels, they work with the angel of death. حتى يجلس عند رأسي. Angel of death, he sits on at the head. He doesn't take it. They bring everything to him, joint after joint. And he just takes it from the top of the person's head. But the way he takes it out is by what? فيقول, he will say, يا أيتها النفس الطيبة أخرجي إلى مغفرة من الله والإضوان. Oh you righteous soul who lived by Allah's religion, who stuck to the deen of Allah privately and publicly, feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The angel doesn't even touch him. He just says, come out. Come out to what like him? إلى مغفرة من الله ورضوان. Allah has forgiveness and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala being pleased with you. Come out for it. This is what is meant by والناشطات نشطا. والناشطات نشطا is the second ayah, right? It means when the ruh is being taken out of the believer. It is like a knot. You know when you make a knot? والناشطات is a knot. And the knot has one rope that's sticking out of it. And you just pull it like that and the knot just opens quickly. That's nashd in the Arabic language. That's the ease that you open it. You don't have to put your nail in it and unknot it. You just press it like that and it quickly opens. The way that it will take it out of the Muslim, mu'min's body is like that. You won't feel it. The ruh will be taken out of him quick. وَالنَّازِعَاتِ غَرْقًا is the disbeliever. And this hadith is evidence for it. It will say, يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةُ أُخْرُجُ إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانٍ فَتَخْرُجُ ذَا النَّفْسُ كَمَا تَسِيلُ كَمَا تَسِيلُ الْقَطْرَةُ مِنْ فِي السِّقَاءِ. The way that the nafs will come out of that person is like water comes out from the jug. Smooth, just quickly falls up, pours out. The way when you pour water from a jug, it comes out easily, no struggle, no nothing. This is the way that this person, his nafs will come out from him. The nafs will want to leave this body. Why? Because it's heading towards where? إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانٍ. It's heading towards Allah's forgiveness. And it is heading towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being pleased with it. It will come out. فَيَأْخُذُهَا. Then the angel will take it, will grab it. فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا. This angel of death, when it grabs it, لَمْ يَدَعْهَا فِي يَدِهِ طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ. It won't hold it in his hand for even a split second, for an eye blink. What does it do? It's holding a shroud. This shroud brought from Jannah, mixed with the fragrance of Jannah. As soon as he grabs that nafs, nafs which is طَيِّبَة, righteous soul, it will place it in this shroud that it's got, the cloth that it's holding. فَيَجْعَلُهَا فِي ذَلِكَ الْكَفَنِ وَفِي ذَلِكَ الْحَنُوطِ وَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا كَأَطْيَلِ نَفْحَةٍ. And this person whose nafs is now placed in the kafan, and the hanut is mixed with it, the fragrance, it's going to be the best smell that a person can ever smell. The Prophet says, عليه الصلاة والسلام, كَأَطْيَبِ نَفْحَةِ مِسْكٍ مُجِدَتْ عَلَى وَجْهِ الْأَرْضِ. The best musk that you will ever smell on this face of this earth, this smells better than it. فَيَسْعَدُونَ بِهَا. Then the angels will take it. This is all before he's buried. This is all before he's taken to the grave. This is when the nafs comes out in his deathbed. The angels will take it. فلا يمرون. These angels won't take this nafs, this soul that it's carrying. على ملأ من الملائكة, a group of angels, as soon as it goes by it, إلا قالوا, the angels will say, ما هذا الروح الطيب, what's this nafs, this righteous individual smell, who's طيب, and they will say to him, فلان ابن فلان, this is so and so, بأحسن أسمائه التي كانوا يسمون بها في الدنيا, they will refer to him the best name that he was ever referred to in this world. They will praise him, give him a good name. It's فلان ابن فلان. So and so. This is who he is. حتى ينتهون بها إلى السماء الدنيا. Then they finish the سماء and they come from to the first سماء where it starts. No one enters. There's doors, there's locks, there's angels standing there guarding it. No one can just knock, go into it. When they come to this door, فيستفتحون, they ask if they can be brought in. فيفتح لهم. The doors will be open, the gates will be open wide for them. Because they're carrying a nafs which is طيب. A righteous individual wants to come in, you will let him into your house. So these angels, they let him come in. They will tell him, come forward, come. Why, brothers? Why is he gaining all of this? No issues, the smell, the fragrance. Because he lived by the deen of Allah. He never forsaked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And today he's not going to be forsaken. Today he's going to be cared for. Today he's going to be looked for. Today everything, and you're going to see what's going to happen for him. Every stage of his, it's Allah taking and protecting him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The angels will take him. And they will take him one sama to another sama to another sama. The Prophet said, "Min kulli sama'in muqarribuha ila sama'." These angels will get him closer to the other one. Okay, take him here. Each angel on his level would aid the other angels to take him. No problem. Go. This is how. This is the way. Go, go. Until he comes to the sama'i sabi'ah, the seven, the final one. When he comes to it, فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, اُكْتُبُ كِتَابَ عَبْدِي. Write my slave. This individual, write my slave here. فِي عِلِّيِّينَ, in the book of عِلِّيِّينَ. Write him there. Write his name and his information in عِلِّيِّينَ. وَعِدُّوهُ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. وَعِدُّوهُ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. And take him back to the earth. Send him back to the earth. Why? فَإِنِّي, for I Allah, مِنْهَا خَلَقْتُهُمْ, I created him from the earth. وَفِيهَا أُعِيدُهُمْ, and to the dunya I'm going to bring him back. وَمِنْهَا أُخْرِجُهُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى, and I'm going to be taking him out of it once again. No friends, no allies, no reputation that you were looking for, everything's gone. You're facing reality. قَالَ, then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَتُعَادُ رُوحُ فِي جَسَدِهِ, his, the soul will be there placed in the body. فَيَأْتِيهِ مَلَكَانِ, two angels will now come. This is the qabr now. The people, all this when it's happening, the people grab the body, wash the body. Once the body is washed, your family are taking you to the grave. All of the times that your family are washing you is when the angels are doing all of this to the sama, dealing with your affairs. Two angels will come to him in his grave. As soon as he gets into his grave, the soul will be put in him. Everybody locks this. We see this part of the reality. We just washed him. The ruh wasn't put in him. The angels are waiting for him in the grave. This minute he gets placed in the grave, the ruh will be brought to him. Until the Prophet ﷺ, he said, يَسْمَعُ آخِرَ مَنْ يَمْشِينَ عَلَيْهِ. He will hear the last person who walks his footsteps. I can hear people walking away from him. His family left him. His wife left him. His children left him. Nothing remains, yakhi. Everything's gone. The angel will then say to him, فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ مَنْ رَبُّكَ, who is your Lord? Questions now start. فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي, this is the believer. فَيَقُولُ رَبِّيَ اللَّهُ, Allah is my Lord. He was a mu'min, believed in Allah, قَلْبًا وَقَالِبًا, internally and externally he believed in Allah. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ مَا دِينُكَ, what's your religion? فَيَقُولُ دِينِيَ الْإِسْلَامِ, my religion is Islam. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ, they will say to him, مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلُ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ, who is this man that was sent out on? Who is this individual that you see right now in front of you? Who is this individual that was sent out unto you? فَيَقُولُ, he will say, هُوَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ, this is Nabi Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ, they will say to him, وَمَا عِلْمُكَ, what's your knowledge of it? فَيَقُولُ, قَرَأْتُ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ, I read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فآمنت به, I believed in it. وصدقت, and I took it on board. I believed everything that was in it. When he says that, فَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ فِي السَّمَاءِ, a caller will call from the sama. And he will say, أَنْ صَدَقَ عَبْدِي, my slave was telling the truth in everything he said. All of those answers he gave, and all of the responses that he gave, he was telling the truth. صَدَقَ عَبْدِي فَأَفْرِشُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. Now, open for him for Jannah. A breeze of Jannah will come to him in his grave. وَأَلْبِسُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ, clothe him from Jannah. He would be given clothing from Jannah. وَافْتَحُوا لَهُ بَابًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ, open a door for him from Jannah. And his grave will be widened and opened for him. Then Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, فَيَأْتِيهِ مِنْ رَوْحِهَا وَطِيبِهَا, the nice fragrance of Jannah and the good smell, and everything comes his way. وَيُفْسَحُ لَهُ, his grave would be opened for him. فِي قَبْرِهِ مَدَّ الْبَصَرِ, how far his eyes can see, it gets open for him. قَالَ وَيَأْتِيهِ رَجُلٌ حَسَنُ الْوَجْهِ, a person would come to him in a form of a man looking very good. حَسَنُ الْثِيَابِ, wearing good clothing. طيب الريح, this fragrance of this individual is amazing. فيقول, he will say, أبشر بالذي يسرك, هذا يومك الذي كنت توعد. Glad tidings for you individual. Glad tidings, بالذي يسرك, that which is going to bring you happiness. هذا يومك, this is your day. الذي كنت توعد, the day used to be promised. Remember when you used to be told about this day and you used to be informed about it. Here it is, you're living it now. You can see it for yourself. فَيَقُولُ, he then says to him, مَنْ أَنْتَ فَوَجْهُكَ الْوَجْهُ يَجِئُ بِالْخَيْرِ, who are you? Your face is the face of a person who's going to bring me good. You seem like a person who's going to bring good news to me. فَيَقُولُ, he will say to him, أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحُ, I am your righteous deeds. I am your righteous deeds, the good that you did. Allahu Akbar. Underline that, brothers. Underline that point and remember it. أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحَ, I am your righteous deeds. That is the thing that matters. That's the thing that's going to stay with you for the rest of your life. That is what didn't leave you in the grave. يَتْبَعُ الْمَيِّتُ ثَلَاثَةً, three things go with the dead. فَيَرْجِعُ اثْنَانِ وَيَبْقَى وَاحِدٌ, two went back and one stayed. What was the thing that stayed?